Howdy, folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Betrayal at Krondor, as brought to you by Jason. As per usual, we're just jumping on in here, and is gonna end poorly, because we have ghosts, I assume, waiting for us. At least that's what was waiting for us last chapter. So, I figure there's gonna be more of that. These things are just so nasty. And there are so many of them. Alright. Oh. Alright, well, I mean, if we can one-shot them, I guess that makes it a little bit easier. I'm tempted. I think I'm gonna try out this Fetters of Rhyme. And we'll just do a little one here. And see how this works. I think I'm gonna have Gorath rush this guy. So actually, you know, I don't have line of sight on this one. I was gonna say, I'm gonna have him charge him because they do range attacks, but we'll just get this guy. Or he'll miss, because Owen, the one time I depended on you, you failed me. Oh God, this is gonna be bad. Why you gotta hit so hard? My hit points. I don't know, these things seem a little bit more fragile than they have in the past. Nicely done, Gorath. You get to suffer for your missing. Man, who'd have thought James would have been the MVP there? The creatures had vanished. They're gone. Let's get moving again. Yeah, we will. In just a minute, I gotta rest because Tinkle Nuts over here borked his stamina up really bad. His barding went up, and so did his strength. And that really looks like about it party-wide. So I'm gonna camp until healed. Alright, it's daytime, so that's good. And I guess, let's see, where did I come from? Where did I go? I think I want to go this way. Okay, so Gorath stopped and stared off into the distance. After several seconds of contemplation, he turned and began to speak. The hair on the back of my neck is telling me that something is out there, something evil. If we don't turn back now, I would suggest that we at least proceed with great caution. I think he's told us that before. Yeah. Oh, this is like Nighthawk music right here. But no. Oh, and they ambushed us. Oh no! This is gonna kill my party before I even get to do anything. Because I'm pretty sure, like, at this point, Gorath, he is well into health damage now. Owen cannot cast, which is kind of bullshit because they don't threaten on an angle. But whatever, yeah, Gorath, you are in a bad way. Owen, you didn't even kill that one. Holy crap! Oh man, this is just bad. Owen, just get out of there. Yeah, Gorath is, like, near dead. He's probably gonna go down if I had to guess this round. Yeah, there he goes. Oh, we are gonna fight this to the bitter end because I don't want to expend curatives, pretty much. Get him, Owen. Yeah, effectual. Man, we're not even gonna have killed one of these guys. Jesus. I don't know. Like, man, I don't know what you have to do to be able to, you know, face these things. Like, especially when they ambush you like that, because, like I said, by the time we actually got to act, Gorath was damaged to the point of being useless, and James is James. And they were pretty good about keeping Owen locked down so he couldn't throw anything or, like, you know, pitch a fireball at him or something. But, I don't know. This is rough. Look at it. I mean, they're just like, yeah, they're just beating Owen down. Death came swiftly. Alright, let's try this again. I was gonna say, if they're gonna throw like five of them at us, and they are, if they're like that first encounter, the one that we bump into like immediately right here, where, you know, we can kill them in like an attack, that's one thing. Cause like these guys, you know, they deal a lot of damage. Which, you know, that's fair. But they go down easy, whereas the other ones, those suckers are tough. Right, so we know 17 damage will kill one of these, so we'll try throwing for 18 and see if he actually hits. There we go. Okay, so Fetters of Rhyme. Oh, that didn't kill it. It appears that Fetters of Rhyme is at least the same graphic effect as whatever their range attack is. But it does seem to stun them, which is kind of useful. Oh, and you've gotten your one mandatory melee kill for the entire playthrough. Okay, well, now that I know that Fetters of Rhyme, that I can actually, like, freeze them, that might be something that could be useful. We'll just rest until the next morning. And I'm gonna save, so that I don't have to keep repeating this fight. I'm gonna hammer my face on this for maybe, I don't know, a couple more encounters, but if I can't really progress anywhere with it, we'll poke around elsewhere. Alright, here we go. Another fight. Yeah, I don't know. They get that first attack. That is... kind of a load of bullshit. I'm just saying. Especially like this. This like angle keeping Owen from attacking thing. That I think is probably the most obnoxious thing to me, because it doesn't make sense, because they don't actually threaten him. Gorath, man, you've got to kill these guys, and you just cannot fucking hit. Oh my lord, it's frustrating. These things deal like a quarter of our health in an attack, and my melees are just like, yeah, no, we're just gonna fail boat here. I wonder. What is this? I think this is like, yeah, that's auto battle. I'm sure this is gonna go well. You need an exit. Exit. Not letting me exit the auto battle. That's rough. What did Owen even do? He's just sitting there like shaking his stick in the air. Oh man. I don't know, part of me thinks that there's gotta be like a trick to this or something. Oh Jesus, this is just a slaughter. Cause like I said, the big thing is that they get to go first. If we could go first, I could at least like, you know, have Owen lock one of them down with Fetters of Rhyme or whatever. So as it is though, I mean, they go first. Gorath is pretty much immediately dropped. Melees, they just can't hit. I wonder, can I do like maybe some pre-combat buffing? I don't know if that would really do anything. Sense magic items. Yeah, I don't know. Got a wrong button. And there's really like not a lot. I mean, I guess I can poison my weapons, but beyond that. Yeah, then I don't really have a whole lot of stuff. I mean, I could have them drink stuff. I wonder if you can use this outside of combat. All right, so what did that do? I have no idea. I'm gonna check it again. Drink another one. Nothing noticeable. Oh, he actually didn't drink it. Probably because he's still under the effects. Head was still swimming from the effects of the previous dose. Alright, what is this? Sword play. Alright, so this should be melee? Melee accuracy? Alright, so that bumped his accuracy and melee up to 70. So I have Gorath doing it too. His should be at 100. No, only 88, wow. Alright, so it apparently has a greater effect on people who are worse at sword fighting. You can't see it, but I'm shrugging. All right, so maybe with this, these two fucking chuckleheads will actually be able to hit something. It's doubtful considering the freaking ass beating that Gorath, I'm fairly certain Gorath is gonna be useless. Cause he's got probably like, you know, 15 health left. James, all right, 90% accuracy. I can appreciate that. He actually hit something. All right. Fetters of Rhyme. We're just gonna go with some cheap castings of this because this is mostly just to lock them down more so than anything else. Are you stunned? All right, you're stunned. Gorath. All right, so your hit chances are pretty good. Just do a thrust and miss because you... The RNG in this game, like, is bullshit. Like, I am calling it now. There is some additional mechanical stuff that's going on that they are just not telling you about because these hit numbers are a loaded duke. I'm sorry. Like, I'm all for, you know, percentages, but at least give me the fucking right ones. Shit drives me up. I think he just poisoned this thing, which is hilarious. Kill this guy. Is he dead? Thank you. Freaking 75 hit points. Asinine. I'm curious as to how long this paralysis is going to last. Gorath, I hate you. At least your poison is dealing some damage to it, because Lord knows you aren't. Ugh. Owen, I guess Owen can just kind of keep running around. At least he's keeping this one distracted. Jesus. These things are just so nasty. Do I? I might have some items that I could maybe use here. No. No? Throw in face of the victim. Sure. Have powder bag. It didn't really do anything, but okay. Wow, Gorath actually killed something. I'm amazed. Oh, and that other one's up now. Hell. Get out of here, Owen. I think I might have, like, blinded that thing or something. I don't know. Yeah, Gorath is just in a really bad place. Although, admittedly, even with his health as low as it is, his hit chance is bad. But, I mean, it's not that bad. I'm just gonna have him swing. Pray for luck. Yeah, James is gonna go down here. We've done better this time. Still not well, but we've done better. So, I mean, that counts for something. I don't know. Curious. I don't think I've actually used Skin of the Dragon. Let's see how this works. Let's do 7. Can I choose? Yes. Hit Gorath with it. I'm just mostly curious to see how much this is gonna reduce damage. Gorath is kind of a lost cause to me at this point. This is more, we're testing things now. We're doing science. How much, oh, it actually, huh. Both of those attacks missed it. That, really? This Skin of a Dragon might be really useful if it's, like, actually that good of a protection spell. I think Owen's probably gonna go down. No. Yeah, wow. Okay, so this Skin of the Dragon seems to be really powerful. I mean, as far as healing spells go. I am just going to fully invest Owen into trying to get Gorath up to the point where he can maybe hit something here. He's got one hit point left, so I'm pretty sure he's gonna go down here, probably like right now. Yeah. All right, Gorath, though, is up to full accuracy. I'm gonna have him swing because it's gonna, like, my goal is to just have him do, like, end this quickly type thing. But I have a feeling that this shield is gonna wear off of him. Okay, this Skin of the Dragon seems to be very powerful. Down, yeah. Cause, like, these things are just, like, non-stop missing him. Maybe it's been a mistake this whole time just not using all of Owen's power for defense instead of, like, what little offense. Oh, Gorath, you're a dead man now. Yeah, you tried. Maybe if you'd hit more often, we would have been able to get through this, but you suck, so you didn't. Well, I've learned, though. Now I know Skin of the Dragon is actually worth casting. All right, so let's try it again. Oh, this will probably be the last time I go at this, because like I said, I don't want to necessarily spend, you know, an entire session here just dying repeatedly, because mostly because I'll get frustrated. very quickly here. We'll have him ice his sword too. Oh, it's the ice or the poison. I have a feeling the ice is probably going to be more damage than the poison. So drink your thing. What is this one? Strength potion. All right. You can drink that. You can drink that. And you can drink that. And I think this is just weapon silver. Okay, this is archery attack bonus. What is this? Far more lethal. So is this just poison as well? Crush it against the blade, causing a blood-like fluid to trickle down the length of the sword's fuller. He would have to take great care not to scratch himself on it. When he resheathed the weapon, the venom would have him dead within minutes. Yeah, so that's, I was gonna say, that's probably just poison as well. But I think that's probably about it. Metallic qualities of swords and armor. Sure. Does it say? It doesn't say, oh my god, I wish these things stacked. It would be a little bit more... I don't know. I think I would appreciate it more if you could, like, just stack a bunch of shit. I wouldn't feel so bad about holding on to them then. Are they just gonna immediately go for Owen now? Naturally? Seriously? What the fuck kind of encounter area is this? Oh my lord. Like, my party can't move. Alright. This is just freaking great. 103% chance. I was waiting for the miss. I'm not even gonna lie to you guys. I was waiting for the miss. Well, James, you can just sit there and do nothing because I don't trust you with a crossbow. Oh my god, this is like right here, this is the game just like fucking me. I got nothing for this. At least we can get Gorath up to like a 100% hit chance. That's something. Owen's gonna go down here. Here, Owen, why don't you try and use this thing? Just throw it at one of these guys. This is so effective. It does nothing. That one down. Yeah, these things, like, these guys are a lot tougher. Owen, just die. Thank you, so that we can get, like, one of our, oh, all right. I'm actually okay with this. I'm just gonna focus everybody's attacks on this one. You wanna play like that? Yeah, I don't know. These ghosts, like, this seems like a very unfair enemy, because, like, Owen can attack, at, like, they have range attacks. That doesn't bother me. The problem is that they can attack on an angle, whereas no one else can. Because, like, if Owen is threatened by on an angle by one of these guys, he can't attack, but they can, because reasons. And, like, that is some bullshit right there. These just seem like kind of an enemy that's here to just say, screw you. And I could certainly appreciate that sometimes, but if you're gonna throw half a dozen of them at me, it's just like, fuck. So apparently, something I've quoted these guys, swords and stuns these things. It might be that the ice damage, the cold, like that. I don't know. I mean, it seems if they could hit, we would have this. Oh my lord, come on. Jesus Christ. Yeah, Owen, you're terrible and I hate you. Drink the curatives. Eat the herbal pack. All right. Let's just yep. There's a threshold of some point where your health hits a number and then you start healing normally. It feels to me like it's like maybe 40. Let's see. Yeah. Alright, it is night. I do not wanna go on at night here. I'm gonna save because that was a load of bullshit right there. I am like, wow. I mean, admittedly, the terrain being angled how it was there probably helped us. Oh my god, another one. Oh my god! This game! Alright. Get in there. Oh. This is just... This is terrible. Excuse me. Skin of the Dragon. I'm gonna go beefy on these, I think. We'll go with 15 points on Gorath. We'll get James eventually, but Gorath is far and away generally the more useful fighter in my group. Although at this point, their numbers mean absolutely nothing to me, so I don't know. All right, so they've both got protection on them. Owen, you're kind of on your own. I wish I could check his stats without the game being like, oh, you wanted to end your turn? Okay, but I can't. Like I said, I want to just try and focus them down, but that requires my fucking party members. I'm sorry, like, I know I'm cussing a lot, but it's because this game is legitimately pissing me off now. And that takes a lot, generally speaking. I don't know. I'm apparently just not in the mood for their bullshit today. Like, 80% chance of hit, miss, miss, miss. Just like, ah. And I guess, like I said, Owen is basically just here to distract these two because for whatever reason they're electing to keep him threatened in melee as opposed to chasing him down. As opposed to using range attacks on him. Game. Owen, you just keep skirting around. At least we're not getting surprised on this one. And with the skin of the dragon on these guys, they seem to be pretty well impervious. I don't know, like that spell seems like ridiculously powerful if it just makes attacks miss you for however long. I don't know, I wonder if it's like a duration or if it just nullifies. Excuse me, if it just nullifies, you know, however many attacks. Well, let's see, where can you get? I think you can get, can you get to here? Holy shit! Go, Owen! Flee in terror! Is that one? Alright, we have killed one! It's a miracle! Let's get this guy. James has yet to hit anything, even though he has got like a 60% chance to hit, because random numbers apparently hate me. Alright, so Owen can cast. So I'm gonna have Owen cast a Gift of Sun. Owen at this point is totally a sacrificial being. I assume this is James. His whole point is to keep these two in fighting condition so that they can actually kill these things. Cause he ain't gonna be doing shit. That much I have determined. So he can get beaten down. I've got restoratives. I don't really care about the well-being of Owen. I just want him to at least keep these two distracted. Let's see here. Where can you run, Owen? Where can you go? You can go here. Oh, hey, James hit something. I think that's the first time he's hit anything this entire fight. It's a miracle. Down, down. Yes, no, no. Owen, I see your speed is reduced because you've taken a bit of a beating. I don't care. Down? Jesus, how much health does this thing have? Thought we had hit it. This should kill it then, yes. Okay, I was gonna say, I thought we had hit it the requisite number of times. Although admittedly, James' attacks don't hit too hard. Still though, man, Owen, I would love for you to get away from these things long enough to maybe drop another steel, like a steel fire on Gorath or something. I'd have these guys drink, but I don't know how long this skin of the dragon is gonna last on them, and as soon as it wears off, they're both dead. So I kinda want them to just focus their attacks on trying to kill things. I mean, to his credit, Owen is keeping this thing well and truly distracted. So that counts for something. Oh man, these guys are just... You can't see it, but my face would tell you a story right now. It is a story of a man who is tired of games giving, like, if you're gonna have, like, 84% chance miss as much as it's missing here, just don't even display the number, because if you're gonna lie, you're not doing anything except wasting, like, developer time. Like, if they have parry chances or whatever, that's fine. Have it affect the goddamn hit chance. All right, it looks like our skins of the dragon are wearing off. Just in time for Owen to go down. So I'm sure this is going to probably, I do not have faith that these two will be able to kill these two things by the time all of the buffs have worn off, because they are missing so much. Maybe not. I say that now, but of course, yeah, now they're gonna just start going down like flies. Yeah. For whatever reasons, that thing got to act twice before. James is just not getting to act now, apparently. Gorath is trying. Oh my god. This game. Like, this is obviously an optional area, but holy hell, you guys. Just damn. Oh my god. This is just terrible. Let's just eat all of our curatives. I think it might actually be, yeah, it appears that the threshold is actually 30, which is good to know. We're gonna need to buy more curatives too at some point. All right, we're gonna camp until morning. All right, I'm gonna save. Oh my god. These ghosts. I don't know how many more of these fights that there are gonna be, but I do not appreciate this. This is rough. All right, so that's magic crap. I don't even know why Gorath has that. Give those. Okay, so drink one of these. You drink one of these. Drink this. Pass this over. You drink this. That weaponizer. It's got two charges left, so I'm gonna have both of these guys use the weaponizer. Alright. I'm gonna save again just so that I don't have to do this again. I do appreciate that they like they let you kind of prepare a little bit before fights. Alright, let's see how many steps we can take. Oh wow, are we done? The road before them was strange, though James wasn't sure what unnerved him about it. There was something sinister about the whole area, and he wasn't too sure he wanted to follow the dusty road they were on much further. "Sethanon ahead," he said. "Should we continue and take a look around?" "Yes." Oh my god, we actually got to the town! Oh. As much a fixture in the myths and legends of Midkemia as the stories of the gods told by the priests and temples, Sethanon was nothing more now than a sad old ghost town. In passing a low brick wall which had been overgrown with ivy, there were struck by the words that had been painted there in sheep's blood. "Remember us." Oh, we can enter. Is this like a dungeon? James stared into the crevasse. Standing on the rubble of Sethanon's ancestral keep, he was shaken by the sight of the thousands of Mordhall bones which had been used to fill the gap into the undergrounds. However interested he was in finding out what lay below, he had no desire to burrow through the moldering bodies. Jesus! Curiosity got the best of him. Dropping to his hands and knees, James began pulling the rocks aside in hopes of finding something of interest. Oh yeah! Is this all moldy? Yeah, I would expect the rations to all be kinda gone. So we have some torches. I'm gonna take the rope. You never have enough rope. Magical scroll of dragon's breath we already have. Danon's delusions. Alright, that's new. And Grief of a Thousand Ice, which we already have. So we got some scrolls. I'm getting the hell out of here. That's like, I had no idea that was like some ruined old town. I thought it was like maybe, I don't know, just a, I don't know. I don't know what I thought, but damn. Will this tell me what, can I click these to get like spell information? No, alas. Ugh. Man, I'm afraid to try to leave All right, let's just go. Oh my God, we're free of it. Oh. Oh. Oh, that was terrible. Oh my God. Jesus. All right, so Dannon's Delusions is apparently a combat spell. Oh, I wonder, based on the name, I wonder if that's like a charm spell or something like that will make enemies kill each other. I want to find like a small group of, I don't know, Cuegian pirates or something running around. Let's see here. Hello, Scarecrow. Oh, come on. There's got to be like some random ass group of scrubs trolling around out here wanting to cause trouble. We actually need rations, too. A bird shot in the sky. Ah. I think we might do well to pay attention to that little creature. Whatever stalled it may be close at hand. If we continue in the direction we are currently headed, I suggest we do so with great caution. Okay. Ambush? Yeah, our abilities have increased. Cool. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Man, you guys, I am like, oh, you better get away from Owen. He's got spells I want to test. You picked like the wrong time to ambush us. We are all like coked up on magical gear and stuff right now. Gorath, I was gonna say, Gorath's gonna like fucking kill you all. Oh my God. Owen, get in there. You're terrible, Owen, I hate you. Down you go. Down you go. Oh my God, whatever. All right, so, I really just wanna know what this spell does. Where is it? Dannon's Delusions. Creates illusionary character. All right, let's, how does this? All right, so I cast it on a person. Let's cast it on James. Oh, okay, this is who we're making the illusion of. Ha! Interesting. So will they attack him? Let's find out. No. But, it doesn't seem like they'll stand on his square, maybe? This could be used as, yeah, okay, you can't stand on the square, so that might be like area denial in combat. That could be useful. Like blocking enemies off of Owen or something. They might attack it, I don't know. It might keep, it does seem, all right, I did notice that that thing moved into melee, so it apparently will also screw with ranged attackers, which could be useful in the case of enemy casters. So that's okay. Owen was on fire, uh-oh. His inside burned like the hot coals in a farrier's pot, in sharp contrast with the numbness he felt in his mouth and lips. The poison that had spread through his system was slowly sapping his strength and draining him of everything but his will to survive. Owen is poisoned 100%, that's great. Owen, that sucks. What do we have? Flame root oil, we'll take it. Yeah, these weapon oils and stuff now, knowing that they're as effective as they are, I think I might be using them a little bit more in the future. We're not gonna bother with that because I really don't do too much ranged combat. Take the rations. See, is it gonna make it easy on me to loot all these guys? It is. 20 sovereigns, a key that I will probably never use, and just more poison stuff. All right, Owen, you're poisoned. That sucks, man. What we got here? This is all, yeah, this is your magey crap. I need to sell these because, like, they don't appear to be too useful. All right, let's see. All right, let's try. Let's see how this goes. How's he looking? All right, so he's still poisoned, but he's not dying. Hey, how you looking now? Oh wow, this poison is gonna be some work to get off of you, isn't it? Alright, so now he's taking damage, so we wanna come in and use another herbal pack. Cause it seems that the healing provided by the herbal packs, it counteracts the damage from the poison. How are you looking? 42, it's slowly working its way out of his system. Alright, looks like he's taking some damage again. I do also have restoratives if need be, but I would rather not use them. Let's camp until now. 10%, all right, so I think he should probably kick this. Yeah, there we go. All right, and it is dawn-ish, and I, in my wandering, have no idea where I have puttered off to. All right, so we're heading down south to Malik's Cross. Okay, so that's fine, we can, we are at 35 minutes, so we'll do that next time. I need to do shopping and stuff anyways, but I'm gonna call it now because, Oof, this episode, this was trying. I think I was gonna go for another one, but I think I'm gonna call this recording session here because after that, I'm just gonna end up raging about stupid things. I accidentally just saved a 29. Damn it. Why would I do that? Save game. I'm saving 28. Okay. And now can I just remove game? Remove game. Yes. I wonder, can I make like another... I do like a second save directory? I don't know if this will work. I'm curious. Yes, oh my god, good to know. Good to know. That means that like what I should do actually is, I think I still have my save, my first like 20 saves. It's just do 20 saves per folder and go from there. Anyways, I'm gonna call it now. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you get a good time. I'm glad we finally got into Sethanon. That was, I think, worthwhile. And I will catch you next time when the adventure continues. Until then.